Thanks again for checking in as we take a look at your southeastern regional forecast. We're keeping an eye on Chris, which, of course, is that tropical storm just off the mid-Atlantic coastline. It looks like it will stay offshore, but we do have an increase in that rip current potential along the outer banks and along the east coast. Spotty storms will continue for those inland spots, and there will be more locally heavy rainfall. We'll get to that in a second. But there's the view of Chris. Again, a tropical storm from early Monday. There's your North Carolina coast and, of course, the South Carolina coast. And because of the storm system here, it is sending higher waves and rip current potential along the east coast, but the track takes it away from the U.S. off to the northeast as we take you through the second full week of July. There is another wave of energy that the National Hurricane Center has a low probability of tropical formation over the next 5 days north of Bahamas, and there's a post-tropical cyclone Burls and moves over the Lesser Antilles. Now, we did have pockets of heavy rain yesterday. Hatteras, 3/4 inch, almost 2 inches of rain in Jacksonville, and from an inch and a quarter in Mobile, Alabama. For today, those peak heat index values will be into the 90s and triple digits, so a hot day coming up. And again, we may see some spotty showers and thunderstorms with all the heat and humidity that is in place today, tomorrow, and even into Wednesday. So again, kind of just watching the spotty thunder threat. So there's Chris. Again, some of the outer banks here, at least I should say the outer bands, could be impacting the region there. But other than some spotty showers and storms, looks pretty quiet here this week.